it is this context in which the immunity versus come in play. Who was a qualified imam in India to give out such a call? Now the answer to is, any person with any requisite Islamic qualification can give out this call. And this is the reason, after Friday prayers, so frequently we see any person who gives a sermon, any imam who gives a sermon in any mosque, it can be a village mosque, a city mosque, he has the power to give that call for jihad. And this is the reason we frequently see these acts of violence. It is so frequent in India, almost there are some cities where the Muslims are 30 to 40%. It happens almost every Friday. At one point of time, it used to happen in Kanpur. Every Friday, because I was brought up in a military camp, there used to be flag marches, the trucks going out on every Friday. At one point of time, this was actually a regular feature. It still happens. It is underreported. And now we have become aware and we have started reporting. But this call can be given in India by any Muslim who is qualified to preach Islam. Some examples. In this, I would like to cite Mopla riots, 1920, which Sir talked about earlier. This was an offshoot of the Khilafat movement. And in this case, the call was pronounced by the Ali brothers, by Hazrat Mohani, and the very venerable portrait of secularism, Maulana Abul Kalam Azad. And that is why Gandhi called them the God-fearing Moplas. In the second case, the great Calcutta killings of 1946. I have not put these incidents there, I'm just reading them out. Consequence for a call for jihad was given by Muhammad Usman, the mayor of Calcutta. But these are not declared or authorized imams, but they are people, they're representative of the Muslims. And actually, what happens is in riots is this, that anyone in the neighborhood can give a call for them. That is the reason the non-Muslim communities are so much at risk. In fact, the risk is more in countries like India. And the exact content of the call which was given by Muhammad Usman was this. It was in the month of Ramzan that open war between Muslims and Kafirs. This was the exhortation that he had given on that particular day. It was the month of Ramzan that open war between Muslims and Kafirs started in full swing. It was in this month that we entered victorious in Mecca and wiped out the idolaters. By Allah's will, the All India Muslim League has selected the self-same month of Ramzan to start its jihad for realizing Pakistan. Jihad for realizing Pakistan. CA protest is jihad for cutting out slices of India. Every single Muslim riot is a call for jihad. The third one, the Holocaust of Noakhali. This was also a call for a full-fledged jihad. In this case, the call came from Ghulam Sarwar, a Muslim MLA. And although the exact contents of the call are not available, Judge Simpson, who was investigating the case, he wrote in his report, large-scale conversion of Hindus to Islam by application of force in village after village happened. In many instances, upon the refusal of the men folk to embrace Islam, their women were confined and converted under duress. Babu Rajendralal Roy Chaudhary, president of the Noakhali Bar Association, fended off the mob from his terrace with his rifle for an entire day and night. The next day, the mob attacked again, and Rajendralal Roy Chaudhary's severed head was presented to Ghulam Sarwar on a platter. And his two daughters were given as guerdon to two of his trusted lieutenants. All these jihads waged by Muslims had the usual accompaniments of indiscriminate slaughter, rape, and loot. These, of course, gone in details in several previous talks. And the last part, who in India is present fighting this war? In what ways is it being played? This is an emphatic statement personally coming from me. Every single Muslim is a fighter in the cause of jihad. Please understand this. Educated, uneducated, a traditionalist or a modernist, a devout or a liberal, a believer or an atheist, each one of them is engaged in jihad. This jihad is enacted in every single action of Muslims. All their choices, political opinion, the causes that they take up, the humanisms that they appeal for. Why do you think Muslims are so concerned about Rohingyas? It is the cause of Islam. Their pre-convictions, their biases, the opinions that they perpetuate, every act or speech is only for the cause of Islam. Every act by a Muslim is jihad. Even Muslims who are unaware of this theoretical basis of Islam, they replicate these acts of believers and help along the cause of Islam through a learned behavior, ideas and tendencies absorbed by association, by observation, and by affiliation, communal affiliation. The Assam enumeration, this thing. They're all victims. Irrespective that a majority of the people who were found to be illegal were Hindus, Muslims go on. I personally know of a case that a Muslim lawyer, an Assamese Muslim lawyer, very friendly with Hindus, he goes to our Durga Pujas and everything. He's fighting cases for these Muslims, illegals over there. Not a single Hindu case has he taken up. Why? Because he's doing jihad. These people, they vote regressively, they foment victim mentality and discontent and nurse sympathies for terrorists and subversionists, advance justification for them, and are the peaceful front which hides the rigidity of Islam. It's alibi to turn away accusing fingers. All Muslims are active or passive, direct or indirect, overt or covert, conscious or unconscious agents of Islam. The small levers in the watch that make it tick, everything is coded to be in perfect sync with the blueprint of Islam. And finally, I finish with this quote of Sitaram Goyal, which I like very much. India has always been and remains the citadel of the most bigoted and bloodthirsty zealotry of Islam. It's particularly important because many times we say, oh, Indian Muslims are more gentle. This is absolutely untrue. The historical reasons for this, why it is so, the main reason may be told. Islam in India has been what it has been because India has continued to stare at Islam as its greatest failure. Islam in India has never been able to relax as it could not do in other countries which it converted completely. And it will not relax till Hindus learn to knock out its ideological fangs, which is rooted in the Quran. Thank you so much.